ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ. ಏನು ಡೇ ಬೈ ಡೇ ತುಂಬ ಭಯನೇ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ನಾವು ಕಾಲೇಜಿಗೆ ರಜಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ರಜಾ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ. ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಐ ಡಿಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಟ್ ನಾನು ಎಕ್ಸಿಟ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಓಕೆ ನಾನೇನು ಎಕ್ಸಿಟ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಏನೋ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಫೋನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಇವತ್ತು ಹಾಗೆ ಇದೆ ನಿನ್ನೆ ಮೊನ್ನೆಯಿಂದ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡತ್ತೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ ಕಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಫೈವ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಫೈವ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಕಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಮುಂಚೆಯಿಂದ ಇತ್ತ
ಇತ್ತು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಫೈವ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು
ಓಕೆ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಡಿಜಿಟಲ್ ಫೊರೆನ್ಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಫೊರೆನ್ಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಫೈಲ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ನೀಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫೊರೆನ್ಸಿಕ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಬೇಕು ನಮಗೆ ಫೊರೆನ್ಸಿಕ್ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ದೇ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಜೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ICT ಆಕ್ಟ್ ICT advances and pervasive use of computer worldwide. Now see, we have even turned back again to the online. So at least some days back, you people were coming for the offline. So now everything is turned to be online. So when we have started using like this online, so we definitely need a security. So that's the reason along with that forensic. So how to manipulate? The details. So in the same way, evidence, cyber forensics and digital evidence, computer forensic, network forensic, then rules of evidence. According to the Indian Evidence Act 1872, evidence means and includes all statement which the court permits or requires to be made before it by a witness in relation to matter of fact under inquiry or called oral evidence. All document that are produced for the inspection of the court are called documentary evidence. Forensic analysis of email, it helps establish authenticity of an email when suspected. Email, the most common means of communication, the subject of forensic analysis for digital evidence. Email system, the hardware and software that controls the flow of email. Components, email server, email gateway. Forensic analysis of email, so it helps establish the authenticity of an email when suspected. Email, the most common means of communication. The subject of forensic evidence, and we have seen the path of digital evidence, media, data, and information. Physical context, logical context, and a legal context. So then email system, the hardware and software that controls the flow of email. Components, email server, email gateway. RFC 2822, internet message format, several formats of valid email addresses, joshi@host.com, so maybe something like this. Digital forensic life cycle. So how this life cycle is taking as per Federal Bureau of Investigation. So you would have seen in so many movies where there are different cases. Some people will say first it will be in a high court, then they will say you transfer that to CBI. So like this, you would have seen in so many movies. So in the same way here also, as per Federal Bureau of Investigation, so what they are saying is digital evidence is present in nearly every crime scene. So what is Federal Bureau of Investigation? That's what we say CBI, right? So here in this, with respect to digital, so we use a Federal Bureau of Investigation view. Digital evidence is presently present in nearly every crime scene. That is why law enforcement must know how to recognize, resize, transport, and store original digital evidence to preserve it for a forensic examination. Digital forensic process. So what is a digital forensic process? The digital forensic evidence consists of exhibits. So the exhibits are introduced as evidence by either a site, testimony is presented to establish the process. The party must show the evidence. Digital forensic evidence can be challenged. Forensic experts formulate a cost of proposal, proposed timeline of activities, list of anticipated deliverables, and a plan for production and turnover of evidence, submission of preliminary risk analysis for the forensic service being proposed.
So this is how we see about a digital forensics. What is digital forensic lifecycle says to us is, as per of Federal Bureau of Investigation, when they start investigating, what they say is that digital evidence definitely it will be present. That's what they say. Digital evidence is present in nearly every crime scene. So wherever we see one or the other thing, so they say we definitely will get a digital, either maybe a phone call, either it may be a message, either it may be web camera details. Definitely, what they say, these people, FBI people, what they say, wherever there is a crime scene, definitely digital evidence will be there. How? So you can see, even in a road accidents also, what we see is, we see that cameras are there. So who, because they want later evidences, right? So cameras are there. So camera is what, again, a digital evidence. So it is capturing the accidents happened. So that is one thing. The same way you can see nowadays, everywhere we have a digital evidence. Either it may be through WhatsApp, either it may be through Facebook, either it may be phone or message, whatever it is. So as per Federal Bureau of Investigation view, digital evidence is present in nearly every crime scene. That is why law enforcement must know how to recognize, seize, transport, and store original digital evidence to preserve it for a forensic examination. So, digital forensic process, digital forensic evidences consist of exhibits. The exhibits are introduced as evidence per evidence by either side. Testimony is presented to establish the process. The party must show the evidence. Digital forensic evidence can be challenged. Forensic experts formulate a cost proposal, proposed timeline of activities, list of anticipated deliverables, and a plan for production and turnover of evidence. Submission of a preliminary risk analysis for forensic service being proposed. So that's what we can see. Digital forensic process. Digital forensic evidences consist of exhibits. Digital forensic evidences consist of exhibits. So now you can see wherever there is a crime scene, you can they'll go and check out what are the evidences they can get. So that is what are the digital evidences we can get. The exhibits are introduced as evidence by either side. Testimony is present to establish the process. The party must show the evidence. Digital forensic evidence can be challenged. Forensic experts formulate a cost proposal, proposed timeline of activities, list of anticipated deliverables, and a plan for a production and turnover of evidence. So, submission of preliminary risk analysis for forensic service being proposed. Then, what are the phases of computer forensic or a digital forensic? Preparation and identification. So, we can see, you would have seen in so many movies where they try to save the Drishyam movie only, you can see Drishyam 1 and Drishyam 2, how they are doing preparation. So first, hero will prepare himself because he know his family members have done some crime, but he want to protect his family. So what he'll do, he prepare. So he prepare and identifies. So he will identify. You would have seen that he will take a false bus tickets, he will take false restaurant movie tickets like this. He take false thing, not the original one. So that's what here, preparation and identification. Then collecting and recording. So he start, he knows that definitely he's so clever that maybe next because everything is based on evidence. So he creates the evidence as if it is happened. So collection and recording, storing and transportation. So you can see how he has stored all the tickets, restaurant bills, everything he keeps. When the police people ask him, why do you keep all these tickets, restaurant movie tickets, he says, we are middle class people, so we have to keep track of our one rupee. So that's what here you can see how clever people are. How, just think about that movie. In the same way, we can think about so many other things. Preparation and identification, collection and recording, storing and transporting, examination and investigation, analysis, interpretation and attribution, reporting and testifying. So collecting, so you can see phases. What are the different phases in computer forensic and digital forensic? First, they start preparing preparation. and identification. Then what next they'll do? Collect and record. So we start, first he'll identify. So what happened, where it has happened. You can see the dead body has been taken and he buried the dead body. Later he changed it because his family member have noticed it. So that if someone comes and informs, then he shifts that body. See, all these preparation and identification. So the small kids, they don't know how to manipulate. So that's what here identification. Then collection and recording. So he start collecting all the evidences. Then storing and transportation. So they start storing the information. That's what transportation, bus tickets he takes, he collects and keeps all these evidences he start collecting. So in the same way, after that day, when police comes and asks him, he start examining. He shows, see, this is not the truth. So that's what investigation. Analysis, interpretation and contribution. So analyze, then interpret and contribution. Then reporting and testifying. Then collecting and recording digital evidence, computer, cell phones, digital cameras, hard drives, CD-ROM, USB memory device, digital thermometers. Then black box, inside automobiles, RFID tags and web pages. So when we are collecting the evidence, so we use a computer because there will be some evidence of doing with respect to computer. The same way cell phone also, they would have called for some people. We can collect how the you calling the cell phone, we can get some evidence to whom he has lost call. What was the record, what was the conversation, like this, the phone call. The same way digital cameras, so I told you, even in the traffic also, traffic signals also, everywhere you can see in Bangalore, not only in Bangalore, everywhere, there are cameras, so digital cameras, so that they can monitor in case if there is any crime. So in the same way, hard drives, so they start collecting the hard drive because we keep everything in the hard drives. All evidences will be there in the hard drive. Then CD-ROM, then USB memory device, a digital thermometer, black box, inside automobiles, RFID tags, and web pages. Collecting and recording the digital evidence. So we can see sources, how do we collect? We collect a computer, cell phone, digital cameras, hard drives, CD, USB memory, digital thermometer, black box inside automobiles, RFID tags and web pages. Like this, we start collecting all the evidences with respect to a digit. Storing and transporting digital evidence, image, computer, media, using a write blocking tool to ensure that no data is added to the suspect evidence. Establish and maintain the chain of custody. Document everything that has been done. Only use tools and methods that have been tested and evaluated to validate their accuracy and reliability. Care must be taken in transportation to prevent spoilation. In a hot car, digital media, tents, to lose the bits. Care must be taken to preserve chain of custody and assure that witness can testify accurately about what took place. So this is how we see the storing and transporting digital evidence. Hey, team people, where are others? Where are your other classmates? Today's date is 21. Amrish?
Yes, ma'am.
Anu?
Present, ma'am.
Ashok? Benita? Pavishya?
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Ashok is present. Amrish is present.
Yes, ma'am. We are in the same room, ma'am. Ashok.
Ashok, okay. Pavishya?
Present, ma'am.
Chaitra?
Present, ma'am.
Deeksha?
Present, ma'am.
Deepika?
Present, ma'am.
Murli Krishna. Harshit.
Present, ma'am.
Murli Krishna Ilva. Murli Krishna. Kishore.
Present, ma'am.
Manjunath.
Yes, ma'am.
Naina.
Yes, ma'am.
Nilanjan. Nilanjan. Nishant. Rajeshwari.
Present, ma'am.
Ramya.
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi.
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi. Ayaka Rashmi, in Ushar, Ushar Ilva. In a voice, I'll change again. Srinivas.
Breakfast, ma'am. Okay,
okay. ಅಲ್ಲ ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ಏನ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಬಟ್ ನೀವು ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಭಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ ಸುನೀಲ್.
ನಾನು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಓಕೆ
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಅಶೋಕ್. ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಅಶೋಕ್ ಹಾಕಿದೀರಿ, ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಒಂದೇ ರೂಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ ಅಂತ. ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ನೀಲಾಂಜನ್.
ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಯಾ ನೀಲಾಂಜನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಡ್. ನಿಶಾಂತ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್? ನಿಶಾಂತ್.
No, ma'am, he is not there.
He is not there, no?
Ma'am, he is just left, ma'am. Maybe some network issue.
Network issue. Okay. Okay, only one. Murli Krishna is there? Murli Krishna, are you there? Okay. Okay, so we'll continue. I just took break for myself. Okay. Okay, so how do they collect and record digital evidence using computer, cell phone, digital cameras, hard drive, CD-ROM, USB memory? So they use all these to collect and record the evidence. So that's what you would have seen in so many movies. Cameras, if there is something in camera, they try to destroy that camera only. If there is any evidence. So in the same way, there are different ways, even in the phone, even in the camera, hard drive, suppose some people would have been saved in hard disk, maybe in ROM. So nowadays you can see maybe even in pen drive, in digital thermometers. The advanced instruments, they can store everything. So that's what we can see. So earlier days, nowadays, even in your digital wearing, you may wear Google's watch. There are so many things. In button only, it looks as if it is a camera. So that is what digital thermometer. Then black box inside automobile, RFID tag and web pages. Storing and transporting digital evidence, image captured media using write blocking tools to ensure that no data is added to the suspected device, establish and maintain the chain of custody. So how do we store and transporting digital evidence? So how do we send? So now you can see, even the image, text, so everything we are sending through the WhatsApp. So WhatsApp groups are there. So what is that? Image computer media using a write blocking tools to ensure that no data is added to the suspected device. So in the same way, now suppose, how do we trust our mobile? Because how do we know that in the mobile there is no virus? So like this, there are so many things. So we can suspect the devices also. So there are so many things. So establish and maintain the chain of custody. So they try to maintain and establish the chain of custody. Document everything that has been done. Only use tools and methods that have been tested and evaluated to validate their accuracy and reliability. Care must be taken in transport to prevent spoilation. In a hot car, digital media tend to lose bits. So that's what we can see, storing and transporting digital evidence. Image computer media using the write blocking tools to ensure that no data is added to the suspected device. Establish and maintain the chain of custody. Document everything that has been done. Only use tools and methods that have been tested and evaluated to validate their accuracy and reliability. Care must be taken in transportation to prevent spoilation in a hot car. Digital media tends to lose a bits. Care must be taken to preserve chain of custody and assure that witness can testify accurately about what took place. So that's what you would have seen in the Drishyam movie one, where the mother is IG and she calculates what has happened, to what he has done, what the hero has done, everything. That's what here the chain of custody is, they'll be assuring and how the hero has taken. That's what she'll be saying. No, I can guarantee that it is created a false evidence. That's what the IG is saying. So that's what we can see. Okay, in storing and transporting digital evidence, image, computer, media, using write blocking tools to ensure that no data is added to the suspected device. So that's what she'll be saying. She'll be suspecting. So how he recreates. So this is just one example. Like this, you could have seen so many places where they try to create evidence, new one, so that saying that the original one is being hidden. So, but in digital, they have to try to get back the original one. So image, computer, media, using write blocking tools to ensure that no data is added to the suspected device. Establish and maintain the chain of custody. Document everything that has been done. Only use tools and methods that have been tested and evaluated to validate their accuracy and reliability. Care must be taken in transportation to prevent spoilation in a hot car. Digital media tends to lose a bit. Care must be taken to preserve chain of custody and assure that witness can testify accurately about what took place. So examining or investigating digital evidence, special care must be taken to ensure that the forensics specialist has the legal authority to seize, copy and examine the data. Sometimes authority stems from a search warranty. As a general rule, one should not examine digital information unless one has the legal authority to do it. A mature forensic examiners should keep this in mind before starting any unauthorized investigation. So examining and investigating, how do they do the all these examining? So you would have seen that they try to hit hero, heroine, kids also they try, because they want to examine and get back the original evidences. But still they don't open their mouth. That's what you can see. So in that movie, same way here, examining and investigating. Special care must be taken to ensure that the forensic specialist has a legal authority to seize. So anybody come and ask you, definitely no, we will not open. But there should be a legal person who can come and ask you. They should have an identity card and say that, okay, they are from police, they are from CBI, something like that. So that's what authority to seize, copy and examine the data. We cannot trust anybody. They may come with a fake, but we should check out what is the, whether they are authorized people or not. Sometimes authority stems from a search warranty. As a general rule, one should not examine digital information unless one has the legal authority to do it. Amateur forensic examiner should keep this in mind before starting any unauthorized investigation. Analysis, interpretation and attribution. Analysis, interpretation and attributes of evidence are the most difficult aspects encountered by most forensic analysis. Analysis, interpretation and contribution of digital forensic evidence can be re-counseled with non-digital evidence. Digital forensic evidence can be extremely stipulated. Open source tools are available to conduct analysis of open port map drivewrites on the live computer system. Holding unpowered RAM below 60% will help preserve the residual data by any order of magnitude, thus improving the chance of successful recovery. However, it is impractical to do this during a field of examination.
So that's what we can see, analysis and interpretation and attribution. Okay. So analysis, interpretation and attribution. Analysis, interpretation and attribution of evidence are the most difficult aspects encountered by most forensic analysis. And first they have to analyze, interpret. They interpret, okay, after this, this has happened, after this, this has happened. And attributes of digital forensic. How do they identify all this? How do they identify, okay, at this time, this has happened. At this time, he went to movie. At this time, he traveled. At this time, this. So like this, they have the attributes. So that is what is the attributes of digital forensic evidences can be reconciled with non-digital evidences. Then they can match. So you can see, nowadays, everything, there will be a time. So they may, if false one is created in the digital evidence, at least by time also you can reconcile. So you would have seen in some movies, the lawyers will try to get small evidence and prove that, okay, this is false. So like this one movie, in one movie you can see, I have seen long time back, once a Chiranjeevi movie, old movie, where they would have been created false evidence. Then when they were showing the tape recorder, what is that, a video clipping, in that case, there is a church where at 12 o'clock there will be a ring. But these people were proving that it is at 4 o'clock. Only by that point, he could convince the that this is a false evidence. So like this, there are so many movies which we have seen how the interpretation they would have done. So digital forensic evidence can be extremely stipulated. Open source tools are available to conduct analysis of open port map drives on the live computer system. Holding unpowered RAM below minus 60 degree will help preserve the residual data by an order of magnitude, thus improving the chance of successful recovery. However, it is impractical to do this during the field of examination. That's what analysis, interpretation, and attribution. Analysis, interpretation, and attribution of evidence are the most difficult aspects encountered by most forensic analysts. Analysis, interpretation, and attribution of digital forensic evidence can be reconciled with the non-digital evidence. Digital forensic evidences can be extremely stipulated. Open source tools are available to conduct analysis of open ports, map drives, or live computer system. Then holding unpowered RAM below 60 degrees Celsius with help preserve the residual data by an order of magnitude, thus improving the chance of successful recovery. However, it is impractical to do this during a field examination. So reporting, a report is generated. The report may be in written form or an oral testimony or combination of the two. Evidence, analysis, interpretation, and attribution to be present in the form of expert reports, deposition, and testimony. Presentation of the report, a complex and tricky process. So broad level elements of the report, identity of the reporting agency, case identifier or submission number, case investigator, identify of a submitter, date of receipt, date of report, serial number, making and model, the identify and the signature of the examiner, step taken during examination, then the result and conclusion. That's what we can see. Report. A report is generated. The report may be. So you would have seen that in some movies they say, okay, DNA report is coming. Then they'll identify whether you are a child or not. If not, the property will be given to somebody else. So like this, they'll be waiting for the reports. So how do they generate? That is what a report is generated. Report may be in a written form or an oral testimony. In some movies you would have seen that a doctor has given. In some movies, they will say they'll bring the doctor only as a evidence. So like this, there are so many ways where they can see. So the evidence, analysis, interpretation, contribution to be presented in the form of expert a report, deposition, and a testimony. Presentation of the report, a complex and tricky process. Broad level elements of the report, identify of the reporting agency, case identifier or submission number, case investigator, identify of the submitter, date of receipt, date of report, serial number, make and model, identify and signature of the examiner, steps taken during examination, result and a conclusion. So that's what we can see here, broad level elements of the report. So there are different reports, maybe identifying of a report agency. So there may be some agencies where they try to give the reports. So you can see there are so many people. If you want something, you can report, give a RTI. So right, what is this RTI? RTI is a right to information. So I want some information. Just take 10 rupees or 20 rupees, post it. I want this information. So those people have to do it for us. That's what the identity of the reporting agency. So RTI is one in India where whatever information we want, you can take that information. That is broad level elements of a reporting. Identify of a report agency, case identifier or submission number, case investigator, identify of a submitter, date of receipt. So the case, when it is identified, who has submitted, what is the submission number, all this. Then case investigator, who has investigated the case. Maybe some people name will be there, police name or some employee's name, what is his number, because they have to know whether that person is genuine or he's also taken some bribe or what. So that's how here, identification of a submitter. So then date of receipt, what was the date they have taken, what is the date of report, serial number, make and model, identify and signature of the examiner, steps taken during examination, results and a conclusion. So that's what we can see, broad level elements of the report. Identify, identity of a reporting agency, that is one thing. Then case identify or submission of the report. Then case investigation, identify of a submitter, date of receipt, date of report, serial number, making and model, identity and signature of the examiner, steps taken during examination, result and a counseling. So the principles to maintain the integrity of digital evidence. So this I'll cover it in the next class. So let me stop. So before stopping, what did we cover? So we started with the digital forensic life cycle. So what is the life cycle when we want to collect the digital forensic? As per Federal Bureau of Investigation, you would have seen, even now also, you can see Ravi, D.K. Ravi was a police person, and whether he is murdered or what, we don't know. So then some people were saying that that case should be given to CBI. So like this, there are so many cases where, as per Federal Bureau of Investigation view, digital evidence is present. So they say that anywhere, definitely there will be a digital evidence is present nearly every crime scene. This is why law enforcement must know how to recognize, seize, transport and store original digital evidence to preserve it for a forensic examination. So now suppose someone would have given a camera and they told that this is evidence, but you have to safeguard. So not only safeguarding, you have to protect that evidence before they send for a forensic examination. So the same way, digital forensic process, a digital forensic evidence consists of exhibits. The exhibits are introduced as evidence by either side. Testimony is presented to establish the process. The party must show the evidence. Digital forensic evidence can be challenged. Forensic experts formulate a cost proposal. Proposed timeline of activities, list of anticipated deliverables, and plan for production and turnover of evidence. Submission of preliminary risk analysis for forensics service being proposed. Phases in computer forensic or digital forensic: preparation and identification, collection and recording, storing and transporting,
examination and investigation, analysis, interpretation and contribution, reporting, testifying. So these are the different phases. First, collect, you prepare, identify, then collect, record it, store and transport, send it to from police station to court. Some, this is a transportation what they do. Then examine in the court, they try to examine and investigate whether it is true evidence or a false evidence. So that's what examination. Then after that, they analyze, interpret and contribute. So then before the judge checks out what are the information they should take. So that's what the analysis, interpret and contribute. Then reporting and testing. Finally, they have to report back. That's what you would have seen. The advocates or the lawyers will be giving, see, this is one evidence, this is another evidence. So like this, they report. Then finally, they'll test and check and then they'll give the judgment. So same way here, even in the phases in a computer forensics. Collecting and recording digital events, evidence. How do we collect? How do they collect? It may be computer, it may be cell phone. It may be digital cameras, it may be hard drives, it may be CD-ROM, it may be USB memory device, digital thermometers, black box, inside automobiles, RFID tags, and web pages. So these are the things, collecting and recording digital evidence. So then collecting and recording digital evidence source, computer, cell phone, digital cameras, hard drives, CD-ROM, USB memory device, digital thermometer, black box, inside automobiles, RFID tags, and web pages. Storing and transporting digital evidence, image, computer, media using the write blocking tools to ensure that no data is added to the suspected device. Establish and maintain the chain of custody. Document everything that has been done. Only use tools and methods that have been tested and evaluated to validate their accuracy and reliability. Care must be taken in transport for prevent spoilation in a hot car. One second. Hello. Hello. Hello, sir. I have class. Another 5 minutes. I'll call you. Okay. So collecting and recording digital evidence, source, computer, cell phone, digital cameras, hard drive, CD-ROM, USB memory device, digital thermometer, black box, inside automobiles, RFID tags, and web page. Storing and transporting digital evidence, image, computer, media using the write blocking tools to ensure that no data is added to the suspected device. Establish and maintain the chain of custody. Document everything that has been done. Only use tools and methods that have been tested and evaluated to validate their accuracy and reliability. Care must be taken in transport to prevent spoilation. So sometimes they may spoil that the evidence. That care also should be taken. Care must be taken to preserve her chain of custody and assure that witness can testify accurately about what took place. Examining, investigating digital evidence, special care must be taken to ensure that the forensic specialists have a legal authority to seize, copy, and examine the data. Sometimes authorities stem from a search warranty. As a general rule, one should not examine digital information unless one has the legal authority to do it. A mature forensic examiners should keep in mind before starting any unauthorized investigation. Analysis, interpretation, and contribution. Analysis, interpretation, and contribution of the evidence are the most difficult aspects encountered by most forensic analysts. Analysis, interpretation, and contribution of digital evidence. Digital forensic evidence can be reconciled with non-digital evidence. Digital forensic evidence can be extremely stipulated. Open source tools are available to conduct analysis of open port, mapped device, or the live computer system. Holding up unpowered RAM to 60% degree with the help of residual data by any order of magnitude, thus improving the chance of successful recovery. However, it is impractical to do this field. So I'll just stop here. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.